today I thought that it would be fun to break up some of the wedding advice that I'm giving and actually do a video about some horror stories. Some little things that have happened here at Hidden Creek that I thought were like uh-oh moments, and I just wanted to share those with you. Just kind of do a lighthearted video and not be so serious about wedding tips this time. I know that y'all are probably getting a little bit stressed during the planning process, so I hope that this video is something that you can not only laugh about but also learn from their mistakes. So my first story is something that we absolutely did not allow to happen. But it would have been a horror story if we had allowed it to happen. So we actually had a groom. They were already booked here. They came, they did their rehearsal. It was the day before the wedding. And he pulls me aside and he says, "Hey, I want to get a rope and I'm going to attach it to one of the beams in your ceiling. I'm going to stand at the top of the stairs, and for our grand entrance, I'm going to swing in like Tarzan." Y'all, I looked at him and I was like, "Are you joking?" And he said, no. He wanted the bride to walk down the stairs, look around and be like, "Where's he at?" And then he wanted to come swinging in on a rope. Y'all, this is a wedding. This is not Cirque du Soleil. This is not some kind of show in Vegas. Calm down a little bit. Calm down a little bit. And then I also had to explain to him that if you grab a rope on the second floor and then you swing over the first floor, you're gonna have a really long drop. I'm not good at math, but I'm pretty sure that's how that works. If you're standing on a second floor, you grab a rope and you swing down, wouldn't you have a really far drop to the first floor? And wouldn't that hurt pretty bad? Because we have concrete, and I feel like that would have been really, really bad. So that was a horror story that we thankfully avoided by telling him no. But girls, let me just tell you, you need to rope those guys in a little bit. Sometimes their imagination goes a little bit crazy. And then horror story number two. So this one actually did happen. It was earlier on in the venue opening, but I think that it's a lesson that everyone can learn from. So the groom and the groomsmen hung out in the groom's room. I always tell people, I don't recommend the guys getting here at the same time as the girls, because the girls have to get hair and makeup done. The guys take, what, 10, 15 minutes to get dressed and ready? So if you make them get here at the same time, that's like 3 hours of them sitting there drinking, playing video games, doing nothing. So that's what happened, was they got here at the same time. The guys hung out in the groom's room. They drank a lot. Comes time for the ceremony, and the groom cannot even walk down the aisle. He is so drunk. So we had to get him some coffee, try to sober him up a little bit. We think, okay, 30 minutes has passed. The ceremony starts 30 minutes late, by the way, because he's so drunk. And so finally we're like, okay, you're good. You can walk down the aisle. And he's like, yeah, I got this. I'm good. I'm not drunk anymore. I don't even feel anything. I'm fine. Walk down the aisle, everything is good. He's standing up there at the front. Bridesmaids, groomsmen make it down. Everything's looking good, and it comes time for the bride to walk down the aisle. She gets halfway down the aisle, and all you see is the groom turn and start throwing up at the altar as the bride is walking down the aisle. He was so drunk, he turns and starts throwing up where they're about to get married. It was really, really bad. So honestly, if there's one thing you take away from this video today, please, please, please make sure that no one is that drunk. It's not good. I mean, honestly, like, that's probably the worst thing that could happen, to be honest. That's pretty gross. So just make sure that your guys are not only getting here a little bit later than the girls, but that they have food, that you're telling them, hey guys, this is not a college party. Let's kind of limit it how much we drink. They can drink as much as they want to during the reception. You want to go outside and throw up? I don't care, but don't do it during the ceremony. Like, at least wait till the reception. So that's my horror story number two. My last horror story for you is that there was a couple and they did not have a coordinator. Side note, you must always have a coordinator. I don't care if people tell you, oh no, your aunt can do it, your mom can do it. No, ma'am. Hire a day of coordinator at least. If you can't hire a month of or a full service, at least get a day of coordinator for this reason right here. So a couple had their whole wedding day planned. They didn't have a coordinator. It was fine. It was a small wedding. It was only about 50 people, so they didn't need a lot of help, which was great. And they had their ceremony. They come inside, and all of a sudden, somebody thinks, where's the caterer? Huh, funny. So we're not coordinating, so that's not our responsibility to deal with. That would have been the coordinator's responsibility or whoever you have designated to communicate with your vendors that day. And so somebody has to go call the catering company. The caterer says, oh, we thought that we were supposed to be there at 7. No, the whole wedding actually ended at 7. It was a Sunday wedding. Catering was supposed to be here at 4. They were going to have an early dinner, and the whole event was going to end at 7. So catering actually had the wrong time written down. But if someone had sent them a timeline the day before, the week before, then they would have caught that error. But no one had communicated with them other than when the couple booked the catering and then confirmed the guest count. So they thought, oh, okay, we'll get there at like 6:30, buffet open at 7. So they get here at 6:30 and people have 30 minutes to eat their food, and it's the last 30 minutes of the entire wedding. So people had to eat cake first because they were so hungry from waiting through the ceremony and there was no food, so they ate cake and then the last 30 minutes had their food. So little horror story to tell you that you definitely need a coordinator to make sure that all your vendors are coming at the right time, because that's definitely one that could have easily been avoided. But I hope this video helps you out and gave you a little laugh, something to think about, and some memories to consider that you don't want to make on your wedding day. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll see y'all next time. Bye.